Today we'll continue with the discussion with the floating point DSP processors. The TMS320C30 floating point processor was introduced in the late 1980s. The C3X families are all the first family of floating point processor, which was later preceded by C4X floating point processors, and then the TMS320-6201. C6X was announced in 1997, is the first member of C6X family of fixed point DSP processor with the VLIW architecture. Because in the previous fixed point architecture that we saw, it was with respect to Harvard architecture. So 62X series, it was a fixed point processor with the VLIW architecture. So VLIW architecture has a separate memory spaces for instruction data, along with all the features of the Harvard architecture. So the C6X architecture given by the courtesy of Texas Instruments is given over here. So we can see that we have separate memories, cache memories, and then levels of memories. So there are actually two levels of memories. The first level of memory is dedicated to the cache, and the second level of memory is separately for this internal memory. So beginning with, it is a floating point architecture. 6.7 series is an extension of 6.2 series. It's a floating point processor based on the VLIW architecture. The internal memory has two level of cache architecture. Level 1 program cache and the same level 1 data cache, each of 4 KB size. 64 KB of RAM or level 2 cache is used for data or program allocation. There are direct interfaces to both the synchronous memories, SDRAM and SBRAM. On-chip peripherals has two multi-channel buffered serial ports, two timers and a 16-bit port interface HBI, 32-bit external memory interface EMIF. So we can see all those over here, EMF, EMIF, MCBSPS, timers and HPI. So the internal buses include a 32-bit program address bus, a 256 program data bus to accommodate 8 32-bit instruction, two 32-bit data address buses, two 64-bit data buses alone, two 64-bit store data buses exclusively for storing. With the 32-bit address bus, the total memory space will be 2 power 32 equal to 4 GB, including 4 external memory spaces, CE0, CE1, CE2 and CE3. The independent memory banks on the C6X allow for 2 memory accesses within one instruction cycle. 2 memory banks can be accessed using 2 independent buses. The CPU consists of 8 independent functional units divided into 2 data paths A and B. So we can see that it consists of 8 independent units and the data paths. The independent units you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and other units for C71. And the data paths are separate, data path A and data path B. So each data path has a separate unit for multiply operation M, logical or operation L, branch bit manipulation operation S, and loading, storing, and arithmetic operation D. The dot S and dot L are used for raw arithmetic, logical, and branch instruction. All data transfers make use of dot D units. The arithmetic operations such as abstract, subtract or add can be performed by all units except the dot M units. The 8 functional unit consists of the functional unit here implies these one. So L1, S1, M1, D1, D2, M2, S2 and L2. So these are the 8 functional units. So the 8 functional unit consists of 4 floating point fixed point ALUs. That is 2L and 2S, 2 fixed point ALUs, that is dot D units, and 2 floating point or fixed point multipliers, dot M units. So each functional unit can read directly or write directly to the register file within its own path. So with the help of its path itself, these functional units can write or move between the register files with its own path. And you can also see that there can be communication between the levels of cache over here, and also with L2 memory, and also with the L1P cache. So the each functional unit has a set of 16 32-bit registers. So the data path A and B has A0 to A15 registers and B0 through B15 registers. The units ending in 1 write to register file A, that is L1, S1, M1, they write to register file A, and the units ending in 2 write to register file B. Apart from that, there are 32 general purpose registers, but some of them are reserved for specific addressing or conditional instruction. In detail, the two set of register files A0 to A15 and B0 to B15 are specifically used for certain functionalities. So A0, A1, B0, B1 and B2 are used as conditional registers. Registers A4 up to A7 and B4 through B7 are used for circular addressing. Moreover, registers A0 through A9 and B0 through B9 except B3 are temporary registers. Also, any of the registers A10 through A15 and B10 through B15 are saved and later restored before returning from a subroutine, or we can tell that they are registers which are exclusively used during branching operations. A 40-bit data value can be contained across a register pair. So the 32-bit LSBs are stored. So we know that the register size is 32-bit, and hence to store a 40-bit data value, we have seen in the beginning that it's a 40-bit data value. 32 bits are stored in the even register A2, and the remaining 8 bits are stored in the 8 LSBs of the next upper odd register A3. So these 32 registers are considered as general purpose registers. Next, the peripherals of C6X processors here, which consists of all these EMIF, MCBS, timers, HPA, interrupt selector, power down logic, boot conf. So except power down and boot configuration, all these are the peripheral units that will relate to this floating point. So EDMA, enhanced direct memory access, it has 16 programmable channels and RAM space, and its purpose is to make the movement of data from one place in memory to the other place without interfering with the CPU operation. Bootloader, it boots the code from the HPI to the internal memory. HPI is host port interference. It is basically used to determine what action the DSP performs when the device is reset. So all these are specified or specific performance operations relating to these processes. So multi-channel buffered port provides multi-channel serial communication link. And then HPI, it allows host to access internal memory. The time and power down unit are the two 32-bit general purpose timers and used to time events, count events, general pulses, interrupt the CPU, etc. Power down unit is used to save the power of duration when the CPU is inactive. External memory interface. This block supports an interface to several external devices like synchronous bus, asynchronous device, external shared memory device, etc. Thank you.